is up, my YouTubians, ODYSEEans, Slayin Sayins, Cobra Kai's, and my pumpkin who be smashing. I am Asherella. This is original Asherella, and those in the know that we just had the 25th anniversary of Adore. June 2nd, 25 years ago, the Smashing Pumpkins album Adore was released. And now this is a really important album in Smashing Pumpkins, like, history and evolution, because we're coming off of the success of Melancholy, and there was a lot of pressure, a lot of expectations and things like that. You know, this is our first album without Jimmy, and so there's a lot going on with this album, and it really marked a new era of the band. And I personally think it's a great album. Some people love it, some people hate it. I, of course, love it. I think it falls right in where it was supposed to be in the evolution of the Pumpkins. And I'm going to talk about all of that as we go today. But today, the song we're going to be listening to is To Sheila from Adore. Now, this is on my top 33 Smashing Pumpkins song list. I tried to do a top 20, couldn't get it down to 20. So I got it down to 33, not including In the Arms of Sleep. And To Sheila is definitely on there. You know, it makes me feel. And if you know, you know. We'll get into it in just one second, but before I do, if you're watching on YouTube, subscribe to the channel. If you're watching on ODYSEE, follow the channel. You can gently caress the notification bell on either platform so you know every time I upload a video. You can leave me a like, leave me a comment, watch till the end of the video, and follow me on the things, the Insta thing and the Twitter.com. Okay, so 1998's Adore. What can I say about this album? There's so much I can say about this album. I'm going to try to keep it brief. Now, this was the first album after the hugely successful Melancholy and the Infinite Sadness. You know, it was very, very highly anticipated. Now, when Adore came out, it was not what a lot of people were anticipating, and it really kind of divided fans at the time. There are the diehards who got it, who loved it, who understood why the album was this way, and then there were the people that just wanted, you know, Tonight Tonight Part 2 or Bullet Butterfly Wings Part 2, and they did not get that. And there was so much going on, you know, post-Melancholy in this era of the band. It was very fragile. Like, you know, this is our first album without Jimmy. It's our last album with Darcy. And you know that there's something going on with Darcy in this era because she's showing her tits off wherever she can. And I'm being kind of funny, but I'm not wrong on that. And then, you know, Jimmy's not there. And we do have guest drummers, you know, temporary drummers, touring drummers, and studio drummers. But Jimmy was never actually, like, replaced. Not in the same way Darcy was when she left when we got Melissa. And I think that really says a lot about how Billy thought the band was going to go in the future. Like, I do feel like he thought that Jimmy would be back. But all that being said, we don't have an actual Smashing Pumpkins drummer at this point. So the album is very, like, percussion light. And, you know, it sounds like nothing else the band has put out up to this point. Now, we get some vibes, you know, in some of the tracks from Melancholy that we get in Adore. You know, there's some foreshadowing in Melancholy that shows where we're evolving to. And if you watch my videos and you know how I feel about the Pumpkins, you know that I feel like the Pumpkins are not just like a rock band that puts out albums. They are a musical entity that is a journey. It is an evolution. We are an ever-changing musical thing. You know what I'm saying? And while you look at Gish and you look at the band back then where they look like some kind of like stoner rocker garage band kids, and then you get to Adore and they're these very kind of goth, very, you know, cleaned up and chic almost looking people, it's like every album is an evolution in the band, its members, its fan base, like the past, the present, and, you know, all of the combined experiences. It is a very kind of dark album, from the minor chord melodies to the lyrics to the album art and just overall aesthetic of the album. You know, it's dark, but it's dark, but it's not without hope. You know what I mean? It is dark, and there's like a sense of mourning in this album, but there's also this sense of hopefulness and like this layer of uplifting feeling about it also, if that makes sense. And my people that know, you get it, you know. And we're gonna be listening to Sheila today, and I think this is a really interesting song. It's one of my favorites. I'm gonna talk about it as we go. I think that's really all I have to say right now. So let's listen to Sheila.
Twilight fades through blistered Avalon. The sky's cruel torch on aching Autobahn. Into the uncertain divine, we scream into the last end.
Okay, so this song is one of those songs written by William Patrick Corgan that literally every single line in the song makes me weak-kneed. It's almost like, how did one person compile words in this way to invoke such an emotional reaction in me? Like, okay, out of the gate, we get twilight fades through blistered Avalon, the sky's cruel torch on aching Autobahn, into the uncertain divine, we scream into the last divide. Like, oh my god. Like, just even saying the words gets me a little emotional. Okay, let's continue. Okay, you know, this song, like other Pumpkin songs, can be interpreted in so many different ways. You know, you can look at it as a straight love song, like Sheila is the love, and, you know, this, your profession of love and how they make you feel. However, I think it is more abstract than that, and I've always looked at it that way. You know, Sheila, rather than being just like some person that somebody's got some feels for, it's a song about an idea, a concept that keeps you motivated, that elevates you, that is what you are striving to be or accomplish or obtain, you know, the thing that makes you live, the thing that makes you you, if that makes sense.
Sheila rides on crashing nightingale, intake eyes leave passing vapor trails.
Intake eyes leave passing vapor trails. Like, kill me, right?
With blushing brilliance alive. Because it's time to arrive. You
Okay. This song is certainly one of those songs that remind me I can feel. That is why I love the Smashing Pumpkins and Billy Corgan's writing so much, because they are able to stir emotion and feelings in me that I can't access otherwise, or I have a harder time accessing otherwise. Like, this song literally makes me feel, and relating to this song in the more abstract, you know, view that I was talking about earlier is like, you know, it's certainly not the only thing in my life, but the Smashing Pumpkins are one of those, I've said it before, unconditionals of my life that make me who I am. Okay, right there we've got, lately I just can't seem to believe, discard my friends and change the scenery. It meant the world to hold a bruising faith. Now it's just a matter of grace. And I feel like, you know, it's like getting to this point where you are losing faith. You know, despite changing circumstance, scenery, that kind of thing, that you are losing your grasp on that. But then you have Sheila, this person, if you're going straight with it, or concept or idea or whatever, that brings you back around to that faith. Do I make sense?
A summer star graces all of me. Highway warm sings silent poetry. And I could bring you the light and take you home into the
to Sheila, you make me feel. Oh my God, it's just such a great track. And, you know, I mentioned you can hear, that's a great example of how percussion light this album is. But, you know, we do get a lot of, you know, unique string instruments and sounds that you wouldn't anticipate in a, you know, iconic alternative rock band. But the Pumpkins, they're not like other girls, right? Not like other bands that, there's a video that people have shared like a ton, especially on shorts and things like that, of Billy being like, we're not like other bands. And it's like, no, you certainly are not, Mr. Corgan. Okay. That was To Sheila from 1998's Adore. I adore this song and this album. You know, it is very different than Melancholy and the Infinite Sadness. But, you know, Melancholy and the Infinite Sadness is very different than Siamese Dream. And Siamese Dream is very different than Gish. So I don't know why people were so, like, surprised and shocked when this album came out. You know, it certainly has gotten the critical acclaim that it deserves over the years. And I just think, you know, it is just another insanely and hugely important piece of my life, and the person that I am and the person that I've become. This is a fantastic album. If you've never sat down and listened to Adore all the way through, you know, one of the things I really love and appreciate about this album is that after the success of Melancholy, you know that Billy and James and Darcy were under a ton of pressure to have another, you know, another amazing record, and they put out an amazing record, but nobody anticipated it to be like this. But I like that Billy and the band did not allow that pressure from the fans, from the record labels, from, you know, everybody involved to force them to write something that wasn't the proper evolution of the band in that moment. Like, I would rather have had Adore than Melancholy 2.0, you know? Like, and I'm sure Billy could have written something that was Melancholy 2.0, and it probably would have been fantastic, but this is where the band was going. This is where the band was in that point. And, like, there's a maturity about this album that I think is very evident. I feel like with the lyrics and a lot of the music, you know, I think, and I don't know this for sure, but I feel like some of these songs were, like, perhaps, like, maybe a catharsis and some closure for Billy in a lot of ways. I actually did a video on the song for Martha when one of my friends passed away, and we know that Billy wrote that for his mother, Martha, when, you know, to cope with her death. And I think some of the other songs on this album were, you know, Billy and the band's way of, like, getting closure on some things. And, you know, maybe that's why there is this kind of, like, sense of mourning to the album. But don't let that fool you, because there's certainly a sense of hope about this album as well. So let me know what you guys think about Adore. What do you think about this specific track to Sheila down in the comments below? I am Asherella. You know, I was inspired my fit today by Adore and specifically Darcy in that era, and I could not find my Darcy horns. She wears devil horns, like, all the time during the Adore era of the band, and I have this little black pair of devil horns, and I could not find them. But you know, she wears a lot of black fishnet mesh and shows her boobs off all the time during this era too, so my outfit today was certainly inspired by that. But I am Asherella. This is original Asherella. If you're watching on YouTube, subscribe to the channel. Watching on Space Odyssey, follow the channel. I know it's not really called Space Odyssey, but whatever. You can gently press the notification bell so you know every time I upload a video. Leave me a like, leave me a comment. You can go to Twitch, find original Asherella on Twitch. Tune in at 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on Sundays on Twitch for Kino and Commentary. It is a different type of content than I do here, but it's a good time. It's a movie show. Check that out. Find me on the things, the Insta thing, the Twitter thing. Happy 25th anniversary to the amazing album Adore and the amazing Changed My Life band that put it out, the Smashing Pumpkins. Always tap in, never tap out, and don't forget to keep on slaying like a Sayin.